Good morning, children. In yesterday's class, we discussed the curved surface area of right circular cone and total surface area of the right circular cone. Today, we are going to discuss the volume of the right circular cone. So, volume. Already we know the volume of a cylinder. We know the volume of a cylinder. Suppose in your textbook is given that activity is given there. The radius of the cylinder is R. The radius of the cone is also R. The height of the cylinder is H. The height of the cone is also H. Means they having the same radius and same height. If you take any liquid, you have to take the two objects with having the same height and having the same radius. Then you can measure the any item with that. If you take the cone, full of cone, and pour into the cylinder, if you pour into this three times, then it will be filled. That is the three cones of milk you can take and pour into the cylinder, then it will be filled. Means from this what we can observe that the volume of the cylinder equal to three times the volume of the cone. Already you know the volume of the cylinder. What is the volume of the cylinder? Right, pi r square h. That is, it is equal to three times. Therefore, what we can say that volume of the cylinder is three times to the volume of the cone. That is, volume of the cone, we can say that 1/3 of cylinder. Therefore, what we can write that volume of cone equal to 1/3 pi r square h. So let us discuss some problems. See that example 6 is given there. A cornucope shaped like a cone has the radius of its broadest end as 1.4 centimeters and length as 12 centimeters. If each 1 centimeter square of the surface of cone carries an average of 4 grains. Find how many grains approximately you would find on the entire cone. So you know, all of you know cornucope. So how it will be cornucope? Cornucope is, if you observe that, it is in the shape of a cone. What is given there? Broadest end as the 1.4 centimeter. The radius of, that is a cone. The cornucope is in the shape of a cone. The broadest side having the radius is 1.4 centimeters. And the height is 12 centimeters. This height is given 12 centimeters. Height is 12 centimeters. So what we have to find? How many each, what is given there? Each 1 centimeter square is average of 4 grains. So we have to find the total number of grains. So means, you know cornucope, that is all the sides for the cornucope, seeds are around the cone. Seeds are around the cone means what we have to find? Right, the curved surface area of the cone cornucope we have to find. That is nothing but what we have to find? Curved surface area of cone. So we know what is the curved surface area of the cone. Right, yesterday we discussed that is a pi r l. But it is given that r is 1.4, h is 12, but we don't know the l. So we have to find the value of l. So before that, This is example 6. Radius of concave R equal to 1.4 centimeters. Height of concave H equal to 12 centimeters. What we have to find? We have to find the L value. How can you find what is the relation among L, H and R? Right. L square equal to H square plus R square. So substitute that. L equal to square root of H square plus R square. What is H? H equal to 12. 12 square plus what is R? That is 1.4 whole square. You know what is 12 square is? Right, 144 plus 14 square. 1.4 square is 14 square. What is 14 square? That is 1.4 into 1.4. 1.96. So how much it will be? 144 plus 1.96, that equal to 145.96. We have to find the square root of 145.96. Yesterday already we discussed that is a square root. Square root is already you know from the chapter 1. So by that method you can find that division method like this. 145.96, you know the division method. By using that method you can do, you can find the square root of 145.96. That is equal to approximately 12.08. I am not doing here square root because already you know very well from the first chapter. So that equal to 12.0L. This is the value of L. Next, what we have to find? We have to find the curved surface area of the concave. Curved surface area of concave is what is the curved surface area formula? Right, pi r l. So pi, that is 22 by 7 into r. What is r? R equal to 1.4 into l. What is l? 12.08. Any cancellation? Right, 7 ones, 7, 0.2. So multiply that, 22 into 0.2 into 12.08. So what we will get that? (53.15 cm². That is approximately 53.2 cm². 53.2 cm². That is the curved surface area of concave. But what is given? Each number of grains for 1 cm² equal to number of grains for 1 cm² equal to 4. Therefore, the total grains for this, that is the number of grains per 53.2 cm² equal to, how can you find? Right. 53.2 into 4, multiply that, 4 to 8, 12, 1, 4, 5 is 20, 21, 212.8. So 212.8 means approximately we can say that 213 grains are there. Approximately the concave has 213 grains. So it is the required answer. Like some other examples are there. I think you can solve that examples. Directly I am going to the exercise 10.3. I am going to solve exercise 10.3. See the first question. The base area of cone is 38.5 cm². Its value is 77 cm³. Find its height. So what is given? The base area of cone. Exercise 10.3, first problem. The base area of the cone. So what is the shape of the base area of the cone? Base area of the cone is in circle shape. Therefore, what is the area of circle formula? Right, pi r square. Base area of cone, according to our formula, that is pi r square equal to, what is given that? 38.5 cm². Its value equal to 77 cm³. So before that, can we find the r value from here? Right, that is r square equal to, how can we write? Pi, that is 22 by 7 r square equal to 38.5. r square equal to 38.5. 22 by 7 becomes like, becomes this side 7 by 22. Any cancellation? 11 2's. 11 3 is 33.5 is there, 11 5 is 55. Next, 2 1s, 2 3s, 2 5s. That is r square equal to 3.5 into 3.5. Then what about r? Under root of 3.5 into 3.5. That equal to r equal to 3.5. This is the radius. And what is given there? The volume of cone equal to 77. Volume of cone. According to our formula, what is the volume of the cone? Just now we discussed volume of the cone is right. 1 by 3 pi r square h equal to what is given? 77 cm³. So substitute what we have to find? We have to find the height. Already we know r from the above calculation. So substituting that, 1 by 3 into pi, 22 by 7 into r square, what is r? 3.5 into 3.5 into h equal to 77. Send all the terms except h right side, then h equal to 77. What is here? By 3 is there, becomes as into 3. 22 by 7 become as 7 by 22, and what is remaining there? 3.5. Here it is multiplying with h, it becomes as by 3.5 into 3.5. So by calculating this, we can get the value of h. So 11 2s, 11 7s. Next, 7 1s, 7, 0.5. Again 7 1s, 7, 0.5. So what is remaining? H equal to 3 by 0.5 into 0.5, 0.25 into what is remaining? Into 2, that equal to 0.25 into 2, that equal to 0.25 into 2, that is 0.5. So 0.5 nothing but what we can get there? That equal to, if you remove that, 0.30 by 5 or 5 1s 5 6 equal to 6. That is height h equal to 6 centimeters. Therefore, height h equal to 6 centimeters. Next, come to the problem number 2. The volume of cone is 462 meter cube. Its base radius is 7 meters. Find its height. So what is given there? Volume of cone. According to our formula, what is the volume of cone? Right, 1 by 3 pi r square h equal to 462 meter cube. Its base radius is 7 meters. That is radius of cone. Radius of cone r equal to how much is given? 7 meters. What we want to find? Height. So from this r we know it is given. What we want to find? What is the known value? H. Therefore we want to find the h value by substituting r in the above equation. That is take this equation 1 by 3 pi r square h. Pi r square h equal to 462 meter cube. So substitute that 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into what is r? R equal to 7 into 7 r square into h equal to 462. Is there any cancellation? Right, 17, 7 ones cancel. Then h equal to 462. 1 by 3 becomes as into 3, what is remaining there? 22 and 7. It becomes as pi 22 into 7. Any cancellation? 11 2 is 22, 11 4 is 44, remaining 2, 11 2 is 22. Now, 7 1s, 7 6, 2 1s, 2 3s, that equal to 3 into 3, that is 9 meters. Height h equal to 9 meters. Next, come to the problem number 3. What is given there? Curved surface area of a cone is 308 centimeters square. That is curved surface area of cone. What is curved surface area formula? Right, according to our formula, pi r l equal to what is given? 308 centimeters square. 308 centimeters square. Its slant height is 14 centimeters. Slant height of cone. What is slant height? Right, L equal to 14 centimeters. Then what do we find? Find the radius of the base and total surface area of the cone. So first of all, we have to find the radius of the base. So pi r L. L is given. By taking again this, I am taking this. Pi r L equal to 308 centimeters square. Substitute that L value in this. That is 22 by 7 into r into what is L? 14 equal to 308. Any cancellation? Right, 7 1s, 7 2s. So r equal to 308, 22 into 2, that is sent to right side, that is divide division 22 into 2. Cancellation. 11 2s 22, 11 2s 22, remaining 8, 88, 11 8s 88. 2, 2 1s, 2 4s, 2 1s, 2 7s, that equal to 7, that is the radius r equal to 7 centimeters. Radius r equal to 7 centimeters, this is the first bit, radius. And what is asking? Total surface area of the cone. Total surface area of the cone. Second bit is that. Total surface area of cone. Say, what is the formula? Total surface area of cone? Right. Pi r into L plus r. pi r into l plus r. So substituting this, you know all values. What is pi? 22 by 7 into r. What is r? R equal to 7 into l plus r. What is l? 14 plus r 7. So 7 7 will get cancelled. That is 22 into 14 plus 7 is 21. That is 22 into 21. Multiply that. Equal to 462 meter square. This is the total surface area of the cone. Next, come to the problem number 4. The cost of painting the total surface area of cone at 25 paisa per centimeter square is 176 rupees. Find the volume of the cone if its slant height is 25 centimeters. So what is given? Slant height is given. Slant height of cone L equal to 25 centimeters. 25 centimeters. The cost of painting to the total surface area of the cone. So according to that, the cost of painting total surface area of cone equal to 176 rupees. 176 rupees. At what rate it is given? 25 paisa per centimeter square. Cost of paint per 1 centimeter square equal to 25 paisa. So actually, for 1 centimeter square is 25 paisa. So what is the total surface area of the cone? The total surface area of the cone, we know that is total surface area of cone equal to what we know, right? Pi r into l plus r equal to 176 rupees. Pi r into l plus r equal to 176 rupees, because the total cost is 176 rupees. So actually, total surface area of cone is pi r into l plus r. So what is the cost for 1 centimeter square? 25 paisa. So this area into 25 paisa equal to 176 rupees. So for 1 centimeter square, it is 25 paisa. According to our formula, the total surface area of cone is pi r into l plus r. So, for 1 centimeter square, 25 paisa, for total surface area, that is pi r into l plus r, how much we can get into 25 paisa equal to, according to our formula, that is 176 rupees. 176 rupees. That is, we have to substitute our known values. What we know? We know L value. We know pi. So, pi, that is 22 by 7 into r. R into L plus r. What is L? Slant height L equal to 25 plus r into 25 paisa, it is 176 rupees. Therefore, I am changing into rupees. 25 paisa means how many rupees? Right. 1 by 4 rupees equal to 176. So what is the meaning there? R into 25 plus R equal to 176. I am sending 22 by 7 that side. That becomes as 7 by 22. 1 by 4 is becomes as into 4. That is any cancellation? 11 2 is 22. 11 1 is 11. And remaining 6, 11 6 is 66. Next 2 1 is 2, 2 8 is 16. So what is remaining there? Multiply 25 into r, r into r, r square plus 25 into r, 25r equal to 8 into 7, 56, 56 into 4. How much it will be? 56 into 4. That equal to 224. So here we are getting the quadratic equation. That is, you know, r square plus 25r minus 224 equal to 0. Here we got the quadratic equation. You know how to solve the quadratic equation by taking the factorization. So factors for 224. What are the factors for 224? Right. Factors for 224 are 30 to 7. 30 to 7 is 224. That is what we required here. R1, that is quotient of R is plus 25. Therefore, we have to take plus 32 minus 7. 32 minus 7 is 25. So we can split like this: R square plus 32R minus 7R minus 224 equal to 0. Now take out common R. What is the meaning? R plus 32 minus 7 common, then R minus also common, therefore plus 32 equal to 0. So R plus 32 is common, the remaining is R minus 7 equal to 0. You know, either R plus 32 equal to 0 or R minus 7 equal to 0. That is, R equal to minus 32 or R equal to 7. What is R? R is the radius. Radius is should not be negative. Therefore, radius is always positive. Therefore, what is the radius? Therefore, radius R equal to radius of cone R equal to 7 centimeters. Radius of R, radius of cone R equal to 7 centimeters. So actually, what we have to find? R equal to 7, L equal to 25. But what we have to find? We have to find the volume of the cone. So before that, we have to find the value of the cone, we should know the value of h. So by the formula, what we know? We know L square equal to h square plus r square. By this formula, we can find the h value, that is h square equal to L square minus r square. So h square, h equal to square root of L square. What is L? L equal to 25 square minus r. What is r? 7 square. That equal to 25 square is right, 625 minus 7 square is 49. So subtract 625 minus 49. How much will you get? 576. 576. That is square root of 576. You know what is the square root of 576? 24. That is the height of the cone h equal to 24. Now what we have to find? Volume of the cone. Volume of the cone V equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. So substituting that, 1 by 3 pi, that is 22 by 7 into r square. What is r? 7 into 7 r square into h. What is h? 24. Any cancellation is there? Write 7 ones cancel, 3 ones, 3 8 cancel. What is remaining? 22 into 7 into 8. Multiply that, you will get the volume of cone. That is 22 into 7 into 8 equal to 1232 centimeter cube. This is the volume of required cone. Next, come to the problem number 5. Read the problem number 5. What is that? From a circle of radius 15 centimeters, a sector with angle 216 degrees is cut out and its bounding radii are bent so as to form a cone. Find its value. Find its value. We have to understand the problem properly. Once again, read. If you are read out, read once again. Circle. Suppose this is the circle of the radius 15 centimeters. What we are taking is taking only the 216 degrees. This is the 216 degrees sector only. Its radius is 15 centimeters. Radius is 15 centimeters. So he is taking only the part of the circle, that is the sector. Part of the circle, sector. See, this is a, like this, it is a part of the circle sector. Its radius is 15 centimeters. The angle is 216 degrees. It is folded like the cone by joining these two radii, that is the, it becomes as the cone. So when the circle is transforming into the cone, what is happening you have to observe. When we fold like this, the area of a sector is equal to the area of sector is becomes as the curved surface area of the cone. Once again observe that area of sector is equal to the curved surface area of the cone. Next, it is the length of the sector. Length of the sector is nothing but length of the sector becomes as the circumference of the cone. Length of the sector is becomes as the circumference of the cone. Therefore, we can conclude from this, what is given? Radius of circle R equal to 15 centimeters. Equal to 216 degrees. What we know, the area of sector is equal to area of sector is equal to what is it? Curved surface area of cone. Curved surface area of cone. So therefore, what is the area of the sector? We know that area of sector formula is, what is that? X degrees by 360 into pi r square, according to this formula. So I am writing here. Area of the sector is X degrees by 360 into pi r square equal to, that is a curved surface area of the cone. Actually, what is the curved surface area of the cone? Curved surface area of the cone is pi r l. So when we transforming this sector into the cone, this radius is becomes as the slant height of the cone. That is, slant height of the cone is nothing but how much here? 15 centimeters. Therefore, we can write that slant height of cone equal to radius of circle equal to 15. So therefore we can substitute in this, that is, what is x degrees means here? 216 by 360 into pi r square. This is, this r is radius of circle. Therefore 15 into 15 equal to pi. Here r, r is radius. Radius of whose radius? Radius of cone. We don't know. And L is the slant height of the cone. Slant height. What is the slant height of cone? Is nothing but the radius of circle. That is also 15. Is there any cancellation? Right? Both sides pi pi will get cancelled. And 15, 15 will get cancelled. And remaining what is there? So, pushable 4 9s, 36, 90. Here 4 5 is 20 and 4 4 is 16. And next with 5 table, 5 3 is 15, 5 1 is 5, what is remaining? 5 8 is next, 18 1 is 18, 18 3 is 54. So what is remaining there? 3 into 3, 9 equal to r, that is radius of cone equal to 9 centimeters. Therefore, radius of cone r equal to, radius of cone equal to 9 centimeters. From this we got the radius. Next, area of sector is equal to the root surface area of the cone. What is the length of the sector? Length of the sector becomes as the circumference of the cone. That we have to observe. Length of sector is equal to circumference of circumference of a cone. What is the length of the sector? That is again x degrees by 360 into 2 pi r equal to curved surface area of the cone. That is, what is the curved surface area of the cone means? It is in the form of a L, curved surface area of the cone. Just observe here, length of the sector, that is already we find the r value, we know r value. So what we have to find actually? Value. We have to find the value. How can we find the value? Value of cone is right 1 by 3 pi r square h. We know r value, we know l value, that is slant height of cone, radius of cone equal to L equal to 15. What we know? Slant height L equal to 15. Radius of cone R equal to 9. We have to find the value of H. That is, we know that. What is that? L square equal to h square plus r square by the formula. That is, h square equal to l square minus r square. That is, h square equal to h equal to square root of l. What is l means? 15 square minus r, that is 9 square. that equal to how much it is 225 minus 49. How much it will be h equal to square root of 225 minus 49 is 144. Square root of 144 is 12. That is h equal to 12 centimeters. Actually, what we have to find? Find its value. The value of pole. Value of pole B equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. We know all the values. 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into what is r? R equal to r square is, that is 9 into 9 into what is h? H equal to 12. That equal to any cancellation? 3 ones, 3 threes. So 22 by 7 we can write as, that is 3.142 into, that is 27 into 12. What is that? 3.142 into 27 into 12. That equal to how much it is 3.142 into 27 into 12 is, that is 324. So the total is 3.14 into 324. That is 1018.008. That is approximately we can say that 1018 centimeter cube. Approximately. This is the required value of the cone. So with this, I'm starting the class. Next problem onwards, we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.